It is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Natty. How are you? I hope you've recovered from our rather eventful trip to Hogsmeade.
I am well, but I have been worried about you, my friend. With Ranrock and Rookwood and Harlow after you?
I'm all right at the moment.
We did not speak about it at the time, but I am hoping now you might tell me why they were looking for you.
I've never met Rookwood or Harlow. Perhaps they mistook me for another student.
A bit odd. The two of them pursuing a Hogwarts student so intently. But whatever the reason, you were clearly in danger. For now, it is safe to say that Rookwood and Harlow are a threat to both of us, to all of us. Which is why I wanted to speak to you. I realized something that day in Hogsmeade. You displayed such courage fighting that troll, and Serona wasn't intimidated one bit by Rookwood and Harlow. Both of you have inspired me to take a stand of my own.
What sort of stand?
Men like Rookwood and Harlow are the reason my mother and I left Matibililand. I am not going to sit by and watch them destroy my new home.
Good. Rookwood and Harlow are a dangerous pair. And the fact that they're working with Ranrock, well...
All the more reason they must be stopped. Rumor has it that Theophilus Harlow runs Rookwood's day-to-day operations. Taking him down would cripple Rookwood's entire enterprise.
That may be true, but shouldn't Officer Singer handle someone like Harlow?
I spoke with her. She was polite, but perhaps understandably would not discuss details with a student. I overheard some of Rookwood's lot talking about a massive poaching operation that Harlow is planning. I was thinking that we could investigate a bit, try to get the evidence that Officer Singer needs.
All right, but how?
I am going to watch and listen, find out precisely what Harlow is up to. I shall reach out when I know more. In the meantime, remember, I am here if you need me.
Thank you, Natty.
Be on your guard.
I beg your pardon! How dare you threaten me?
What's going on here?
I've no idea who it is you think I might have seen. I've been busy with my research. I do not have time to...
Victor Rookwood don't give a doxy's nip back your time. Oi! Speak of the devil. Mr. Rookwood would like a word with you.
A student? You can't be serious.
Enough out of you.
Leave her alone.
Stupefy!
Let's get this over with, shall we?
I will not be cast about for your amusement!
You want to play like that, do you? Try dodging this lot.
You insolent crap-like!
Oh, dear. Fighting with blood? You don't stand a chance!
I'll watch the light go out of your eyes.
You're going to regret that. No!
What on earth just happened? I've never been accosted in such a manner, and so close to Hogwarts.
Are you all right?
I am, thanks in no small part to your excellent defensive skills. Care to tell me why two Ashwinders were ready to dispatch me to get to you?
Ashwinders?
Victor Rookwood's thieves and extortionists, his little cronies. They seemed quite keen on you.
It's a long story, but thank you for your help.
Well, you've avoided them for the moment. Priya warned me things were getting dangerous. Best get moving on my research before they return.
You mentioned someone named Priya.
Yes, my wife. She's the one who piqued my interest in Merlin, gave me a book when we were students at Hogwarts. Typical hard-working Hufflepuff, brilliant potioner, has her own shop in Nocturne Alley. She's a travelling vendor, hears what's going on in the Highlands before I do.
You're a researcher?
Nora Treadwell at your service, historian and archaeologist specialising in Merlin's work and life.
Merlin? Of the legend of King Arthur?
The very same. Merlin attended Hogwarts, you know, and I'm studying some curious fixtures he left here centuries ago.
Fixtures?
These vine-covered pillars, dozens of them, all around the area. I've taken to calling them the Trials of Merlin. I believe he created them as a diversion for his fellow Slytherins. He was terribly fond of puzzles and enigmas.
I can see why you're so interested in Merlin. I'd be keen to know more about the trials.
Well then, I'll let you in on a little secret. No one has yet managed to figure out how they work. But I believe I have just unlocked a crucial clue. I suspect that mallow sweet is an important component in getting the trials to work.
Mallow sweet?
Versatile herb. Merlin repeatedly mentioned it in his writings. I had just arrived to test my theory when I was so rudely interrupted. You see, each swirl in Merlin's writing has its symbol in the centre. That started me thinking, what if...
The mallow sweet is meant to be placed at the centre of the symbols.
Precisely. Would you care to do the honours? We can see what comes of our little hypothesis. I brought a trunk chock full of mallow sweet with me. It's just over there by my tent.
This trunk?
Yes, take plenty, even if you already have some.
I have the mallow sweet.
Lovely. Now, notice the vines on these pillars here, as well as a stone swirl on the ground. Each trial has these features. Place the mallow sweet on the swirl, and we'll see what happens.
What should I do now?
This is uncharted territory. I am curious about these pyres.
Thank you. You got the mallow suite to work. Now, what to do about these pyres? A spell might help us here.
Expelliarmus! Incendio!
Merlin, spears!
The flames make the pyre sink.
Back where they started.
Incendio!
Clearly, all three of these pyres are meant to be lit.
Incendio!
Hardly believe it.
I take it we can call that a success?
We can indeed. However, I now have even more questions. How does it work? I must review my notes. I may have missed something.
Are all of the trials like this one?
Hmm? Oh, not precisely. Well, I think each has those telltale vines and the swirl on the ground. You should feel free to solve them as you come across them. I believe I have what I need to continue my research. My guess is that each will also require mallow sweet, which you can find in Hogsmeade should you need more. I really must be off. Such a pleasure to meet you. And do be careful out here. Now, I've got what I needed. I shall return to the safety of my notes and books.
Sir Nicholas, our house ghost, is looking for you. You can find him near the Great Hall.
Thank you. brand new game. Just beware the open flame.
You there? Yes, you. I wonder if you might come with me for a moment.
Were you calling me, Gareth?
I was hoping you might want to redeem yourself for not having brought me that fupa feather and potions. You see, I have an idea for a fizzing, Wisby-inspired beverage, but I'm missing a key ingredient.
You and your concoctions. I don't know how you come up with these things.
It's a gift, truly. So, I suspect the key ingredient in fizzing Wisbys is dried billywig stings. I heard there's a store of them in Honeyduke's cellar. I'd get them myself, but my Aunt Matilda has her eye on me. Thinks I need to focus on potions class for a while, not for my own brews. I was hoping you could follow a secret passage to Honeyduke's cellar and grab a few dried billywig stings for me.
Sounds simple enough. And who wouldn't want to go to Honeyduke's?
Ah, brilliant. Thank you. The passage is hidden behind the statue of a one-eyed witch in the third floor corridor. Just tap it with your wand and say, Descendium.
Couldn't you have someone buy the dried billywigs things?
They're not for sale, and you never know when the cellar's going to be locked. So, the reliable way in and out is through the secret entrance.
Are you asking me to steal from a shop?
Goodness! It's not as if I'm asking you to rob Gringotts. Honeydukes is more than enough, and I only need a few. It's a sweets ingredient. They won't be missed, trust me.
I'll see what I can do, Gareth.
Fair enough. You shall be the first one to taste my newest brew if you can be of help. Perhaps I can convince a meat to help me with my potions homework, get my aunt to loosen her reins a bit.
I'll need to get those dried billywigs things for Gareth if he's to finish his latest concoction. A one-eyed witch statue shouldn't be too odd.
Come with me for a moment.
You wanted to see me, sir?
Yes, Sir Nicholas de Mimsey Porpington, at your service.
Nice to meet you, Sir Nicholas.
I know about the book you found and its missing pages. I may be able to help. Follow me, if you will. It's not too far.
Wait, how do you know about the book? And that it's missing pages?
Word gets around amongst the ghosts. You were spotted with Mr. Sallow in the restricted section. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me. This may be a leap, but I believe I know who ended up with those pages. I'd be happy to take you to him, if you'd be so kind as to perform a small favor for me along the way.
A small favor in exchange for getting those pages.
Yes, it's nothing really. I'd be grateful if you could simply go into the kitchen and procure a little rotten roast beef.
I beg your pardon. Roast beef. Rotten roast beef.
That is correct. Rotten roast beef. If one floats through it just right, one can almost taste it.
Ugh. I suppose I can do that. But why me?
It's simple, my young friend. My ghostly form cannot carry it. Now, if you'd be so kind as to collect the roast beef, I shall explain everything else in due course. Ah, here we are. Tickle the pear and head on in.
Did you say tickle the pear?
Yes, in the painting. I'll wait right here. Do try not to get in the way of the house elves. I'm already imagining the sweet aroma of rotten roast.
Revelio.
A student
never will
from the
understand
kitchen.
Students.
What could
plenty
they want?
Of delicious food and found themselves a bit peckish, likely.
You certainly makes Rookie's job easier.
Here's some beef, but it's not rotten. I'd best keep looking. It smells glorious in here. Here's a welcome treat. Delicious. Pardon me, but can you point me to the rubbish?
None such was just about to dispose of today's collection. It's towards the back. Help yourself, I suppose.
Ugh. There's a disgusting smell. I must be getting close.
Oh, a student? What a treat! What can Finky get for you? A pumpkin pasty? Some Welsh rabbit.
Sounds lovely, but what I really need is this rotten roast beef.
Ah, Nick sent you, didn't he? Please help yourself. See Stinky supposes Nick's tired of loitering about, simply to experience the faintest memory of the taste of food.
Do you and the other house elves conjure the food served in the Great Hall?
Goodness, no. Not even house elves can conjure food out of thin air. Food is one of the five principal exceptions to Gamp's law of elemental transfiguration. We can, however, multiply it, transform it, and of course, prepare it. Then we send it straight up to the Great Hall.
Are there any restrictions as to what you can make here?
Finky supposes not. However, Finky has had the best luck with the many recipes left by Helga Hufflepuff. Her quince pie has always been a favourite, but the newfangled Arbro's Smokies are becoming popular as well.
Is it all right for students to wander into the kitchens?
Well, since you asked, students aren't supposed to be in the kitchens, but Finky doesn't mind. There's nothing that lifts Finky's spirits more than the company of students. We so rarely get visitors, and we have plenty of treats. Come back anytime you please.
It was nice to meet you. Thank you for the beef.
Happy to help, and to meet you as well. Please give Nick Finky's regards.
There's nothing like a meal prepared by a house elf.
You're back. No trouble, I take it?
Not at all. Finky sends her regards, along with the rotten roast beef.
Ah, glad to hear it. Kind elf, Finky. Now, let's get that beef to Sir Patrick Delaney Podmore, and you'll be one step closer to finding those pages.
This is all rather cryptic, Sir Nicholas. What's going on?
Terribly sorry, I'm getting ahead of myself. Sir Patrick organises the Headless Hunt, a group of headless ghosts who gather for various, headless activities.
Headless activities?
Yes, you'll see. Anyway, I don't know how, but a member of that hunt, Richard Jackdaw, had the pages when he was alive. My plan is to take the rotten roast beef to Sir Patrick so that he'll allow me, us, to engage with the hunt and speak to Jackdaw. Shall we?
I thought the rotten roast beef was for you.
It is, in a way. You see, I've been trying to gain access to the hunt for quite some time. Offering the beef to Patrick may help me in that regard. While, of course, also helping you.
What am I supposed to do when we meet the hunt?
Allow me to do the talking. They can be a rather supercilious lot. I'm certain they'll be welcoming to you, however, in no small part due to the rotten roast beef you'll come bearing.
Is the headless hunt dangerous?
Oh, the headless hunt wouldn't hurt a fly, let alone a student. Just a group of fun-loving headless ghosts.
Very well. I'd like to meet Sir Patrick myself and see this headless hunt.
Ah, wonderful. You won't regret it. Do stay behind me. It's Sir Patrick we want.
Oi, Nesta, look who's here.
What have we told you, nearly headless Nick?
Hello, Sir Amzet. Do let us pass. We've brought a little something for Sir Patrick.
Probably come to try to beg his way in again.
Do they always talk to you like that?
Oh, all in good fun. Once Sir Patrick lets me join the Headless Hunt, I'll be right there with them. This offering is sure to win him over.
Don't forget why I'm here, sir.
Rest assured, you'll have your information from young Jackdaw in no time. Wherever he may be.
What I'd give for a flagon of mead or a nice leg of lamb right about now. Then this party would be complete.
How about the next best thing, Sir Patrick?
Ah, Sir Nicholas. And a student. Who let you in?
We brought you a gift.
This is all very suspicious. What do you really want? As if I need to ask.
It's Richard Jackdaw. Where can we find him? May we speak to him?
Jackdaw, eh? Why, here he is now. What a shame. Without his head. I bet you've always wondered what that's like, eh, Nick?
Sir, you jest.
It's bound to be around here somewhere. Probably being used in a game. If you find it, I give you my permission to speak with him, my young mortal. It's the least I can do for you for bringing this putrescent gift home.
Sir, there's another matter I wish to discuss with you, if I may.
Tut-tut, Sir Nicholas. How many times do I have to tell you? Our entry requirements are quite clear.
But, sir, I...
We aren't the headless except for a little bit of tendon hunt, after all. Now, please, follow me and I shall help you find your way out.
Farewell, my young friend. Perhaps your luck with these chaps will be better than mine.